I call on these persons here present to witness that I, Donna Marie Clail,
I, Donna Marie Clail,
do take thee, Terence Arsenal Carter, to be my lawful wedded husband.
Do take thee, Terence Arsenal Carter, to be my lawful wedded husband.
Shut up. Shut up, Donna.
Do take thee, Terence Arsenal Carter,
to be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
She's got my suit on. It's my suit.
Don't you be worried about my suit. Get on and enjoy yourself, all right? Yeah, boys, all right. Talk to you too. Here, Richard.
This isn't so bad. It's moist.
Ah, you've probably got the bit of piston. Lovely spread, Viv. Young girl's well trained. Hey, you should have got a load to do the photos.
Eddie Carter's no celebrity.
They're all bloody celebrities in here, mate.
Keith says, any requests?
Just have a little girl sitting in the back seat.
Aye, and tell him we know what he did with them.
And now a special record for the lovely couple. A special message from the King himself. This one's for you, Terry. And Donna.
Kiss me, my darling. Be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. It's not for me, my love.
Maybe as well he couldn't shag it. You can imagine a kid between Beastie Boy and Petrol Bomb. Meh, meh. How was it for you, darling?
Irene, good night. Good night, Irene. Good night, Irene. I'll see you in my dreams.
I'm back to yours for a nightcap, Mitchell.
Hello, no, I'm off to my bed.
Getting old.
Me?
Is he past it? Can't stand the pace anymore, mate. Just you and me then, Jenny.
Yep.
Hey, is that enough?
He's all right.
Major.
Chairs in your parlor seem empty and bare. Do you gaze at your doorstep and picture me there? Is your heart filled?
I don't know why we can't visit us from inside the hospital. And me and Terry could see each other every day.
Yeah.
We are actually married.
What are you doing?
I'm not looking out the window. God, I want it.
Great choice, Jerry. Watership down. Inspired.
Yeah, well, in 06, he was out with me.
Sure. Where are you going, Keith?
How's the old life story coming along?
Oh, very well. I mean, it's very, would you like to read it?
Yeah. Love to. All right, Gary.
Where's my suit? You bastard! I want my suit back!
Get out!
Where's my suit?
Get
out! I want that suit!
Gary!
Where's my...
Gary!
Gary!
Hey! What's the problem? Gary! Tell me what the problem is. Come on!
He's got my suit. My best suit. I don't want it back.
You bastard!
Gary!
I want it back!
Gary!
Look, Gary, I don't know what's upsetting you to her. And until I do, I can't get it sorted. Now, do you want to have a little chat? Just you and me. All right. Then over to your room. Come on, we can talk in. Growing up fast, you all two, aren't they, Gary? I saw him when Siobhan brought him in last visit.
I don't like her bringing them in here, Mitch. She says they got to see their daddy.
My old man used to have me up here all the time when he was in here. Working here. You're a bit pissed off with Terry, aren't you?
Beastie boy. You wore my suit to his wedding? He can't do that. He can't get married in my suit.
Oi, oi. There's your suit, you twat, hanging up there, all right.
Anything else bothering you? Fine.
He's all right. Told you'd know that bastard suit. Not funny.
Trevor! Trevor! We're having chat. We've got a moment. In here.
Oh, get in there.
If so.
This isn't intended as a personal criticism, Trevor, but yesterday I overheard you making comments about the patients which we felt were inappropriate. You were discussing the possibility of a sexual relationship between Terry and Donna and using nicknames that made reference to their index offences.
That was a private conversation, sweetheart.
There's far too much of this on the wards. It indicates a basic lack of respect.
We have the crack with the patients. They like it, you know that. Of course, we could go the other way, call them sir and madam, have no bloody interaction at all.
Don? Don? Don?
Come in, Richard, mate.
Hey, Sean. See now.
It's good to see you.
Where's your dressing gown? Here we are.
Need therapy?
Yeah.
Contact Faye.
It's only a special hospital.
Stick that in a notice board.
I will. I will.
You might get a tight ass bitch an offer, eh?
That's what she needs! I'm not eating shit! I'm not eating that shit!
Clear that up.
No. You clear it up. I'm not your slave. You clear that shit up.
Well, no, white men don't clear it up after niggas get it.
Get him up.
Clear it up.
Just do it. You eat this shit! You are the shit! You eat the shit! You eat the shit! You bastard! Piece of shit! Bastard! You eat the shit! You bastard! You eat that! You eat that!
See how you like it!
Get on with your dinners. Go on.
You say you are sorry.
You shit the brains, black bastard.
Are you laughing?
What?
Ricky, come here a minute.
Funny. You what?
Come here.
Yeah. Come on. Stand up.
Before he misses with me again.
Dreamt about you last night, Debbie. You, me and Terry were like walking along in this stream and you cut your foot on a pebble. There was all this blood running into the water, and I said...
I did that once.
Did you? I'm psychic.
There's a stream where my mum and dad live, only I cut my foot on a bit of glass, not a pebble.
Yeah, that's right. Your mum and dad were there as well, and they were telling us to get out of the
what
water.
What did they look like then, Debbie's mum and dad? They looked like me. It's funny you dreaming about that stream. I'll take you there one day.
You won't want to know us when you get out of here. Me and Terry's getting out of here. We're gonna leg it.
You're fucking mental. I'm getting out of here. Aren't I?
Oh, come on, Mitch.
Watch, it's time to get up. It's late. Oh, Sarah brought this in last night.
Gits. Well, Don will be at home then. They've got gits in French and all.
You rattled your cage.
Ah, it pisses me up. We had to put a patient in seclusion yesterday and Don got well out of order.
Yeah, well, you said yourself it can get a bit rough sometimes.
Yeah, doing the job, Denise. He was over and beyond the call of duty. Dickhead.
Oh, Don's all right in small doses. Well, you're not going to say you're not going to go away now, are you?
Oh, why should I do that?
Well, I don't know. I just don't think you really want to.
It's a bit late in the day for that, isn't it? But no, I do want to go. All right.
Well, it'd be really good. Something different.
Terry, would you like to light the paper? Terry, how do you feel when you think about setting fire to things? Do you feel sexy?
Uh-huh.
Take the matches, Terry.
No.
It's a waste of time, sir.
It is. I mean, all you've got to go is, oh, no, I don't like fires anymore. And they go, oh, there's a good boy. I mean, nothing personal, Terry, but any bugger can lie his way out of it.
I don't know.
I've seen for bloody days now. Fucking Gary. I hate him. What's he want to go and die for?
Sorry.
Two patients on this ward have made a complaint, Don. They say that you assaulted Gary Walters in the dining hall.
Which patients?
Yeah. Don, under SHSA procedure, I've no alternative but to suspend you from your duties until these allegations have begun a full internal investigation.
Yourself, what are you talking about? I assaulted Gary Walters. I didn't, did I, Mitch?
I don't have any choice. The complaints have been made and we have to be seen to be dealing with them fairly and above board.
Oh, do it. Shit all over me.
We'll see Jerry, the union, will sort this out.
You were there, in the dining room. Did you witness the assault?
Alleged assault, Stuart. It could be that a couple of patients have got a grudge against Don. For some reason.
I want you to go over to Lynette Ward, Mitch. As from now, you'll be working there.
Why?
They're short-staffed.
Well, don't I have a say in this?
I'm afraid you don't.
Discover I don't like delegating. I like to be out on the road, getting things done. Though having said that, I think the key word here is self-sufficiency. I like to encourage people to do things for themselves. One of the nurses started aromatherapy lessons. Are you interested?
I've got a bit of a war with him.
I think in terms of job satisfaction that this is the most exciting war to work on.
Well, I'm a professional lover. I work where I'm told.
Cut the crap.
You started it.
I'm gonna have some fun with you. Ah, Chrissy, our plant monitor. I see you've been lavishing your usual love and attention on them. Chrissy! What are you doing?
Some of these want putting on.
I know.
It used to be apple trees here, you know. I used to come scrumping.
Scrumping?
You never go scrumping as a kid? Nicking apples from people's orchards, didn't it?
Oh, I wouldn't steal.
You want to give me the garden shears now?
I'm allowed to have them.
How's your dad then, Mitch? Enjoying life by the sea?
Hates it, Mike. No Boddingtons.
You know, we've got to take a statement from you about this do-over Partridge Ward. They're up in arms over there. Old Jerry's got some blood from the union down. So what's the score?
Well, there was a bit of a scuffle, you know. We had to get the guy in seclusion. He didn't want to go. I didn't see Don do anything unwarranted.
This is what we're hearing. Well, don't worry about it. We haven't had the results of the PM yet, but it's looking like an accidental death. He wasn't very old, was he?
34.
What was he in for?
Rape. 6 cases. Used to pick on women with kiddies. Make them watch him come on the mum's face.
That's
nice.
That
bloody hell, the club's burnt down.
Knackered.
Looking after the girls all day.
Please had a word.
Yeah? Was it all right?
Yeah. No, you're all right.
Yes, you're bloody right. Come on then, let's get these girls down the old folks home and we'll go celebrate me back at Taliad.
I'm tired.
You go on. I'll catch you up.
Aye, I get it. Mitch is on, I promise. Mm. Well, have I told you? As soon as the kids leave home, we can't get their hands off each other.
I can't keep my hands off you either, but it's for different bloody reasons. Come on out.
Can't we watch?
No.
Tosser.
Shut up.
I've been covering for the prick all day. Can't I say what I think now? He knows what he did to Gay. All he cares about is his bloody job. It's like Gary was nothing. Not even a human being.
But you're all like that, Mitch. You don't talk about the patients any different than Don.
A heart attack. That's the findings of the post-mortem. The police have concluded their investigations.
Great, so Don's back to work.
There is still this business of the assault.
You saw that, Gary. A couple of patients have made up a story, that's it.
The hospital has to investigate every complaint made. The patients need to know that we're acting justly here, as does the outside world.
I'll tell you what. Don's been made a scapegoat. Gary died of a heart attack. If anyone's to blame, it's the doctors. Jacking them up with drugs all the time to keep their even loonies quiet.
They are patients, Jerry, not lunatics. They are sick people.
Don't give me that. I'm a nurse. I work with them. I don't sit in an office all day thinking up schemes to keep them happy. I'm out in a bloody ward doing it. I'll tell you the score. You get a dead patient, and a nurse has got to carry the can.
No.
Is Don reinstated?
No.
Everything you know about him.
Who?
Terry Carter, her husband.
Have you seen him asleep?
Hmm.
What's he like?
He snores.
I wouldn't snore if I got hold of him. He wouldn't sleep, Donna.
Do you like my paintings?
Well, these ones here?
Yeah.
Would you do that one there?
Yeah.
I do. I really like your paintings.
Are you all right? Oh, you're not, are you?
How would you feel if you were going to get jumped for something you didn't do?
It's not going to come to that, is it?
They could put me away, Jimmy's. At the very least, I'll lose my job, and then what'll we do?
All right, Jerry, I thought you were going to the barn at the brewery.
Yeah, it's important we're 100% solidarity in this, so even though you're not in the ward, I want you out there with the rest of us, eh?
What's this?
I'm calling strike action, as of now. All of our shift in Partridge.
Yes!
Hey, I've got to go in tomorrow.
He can't miss the outing.
That's all right, as long as we present a united front come Monday morning.
Show those bastards who really runs this hospital.
They couldn't cope without you. We'll make banners. Yeah, you bring your cups of tea up to the picket line. I'll tell you what, Jerry. We get all the wives together, set up a strike support group.
Yes.
As long as you don't get my wife.
What do you reckon, Mitch?
Well, we're all in it together, aren't we?
Yes, definitely.
Cheers.
Good health.
Cheers.
We're all going on a summer holiday. No more worries for a week or two. Fun and laughter on a summer holiday. To make our dreams come true. For me and you.
We're going where the sun shines brightly.
Brightly.
We're going where the sea is blue.
Blue.
All right, pack it in.
What are you all doing here anyway?
Looking, Debbie Patch, she's leaving next week.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm going to a place in Wales.
Oh. Well. Well, anyway, you can stop now and come down to the car park. The coach is ready.
Hey, you look nice. Much sexier than the suit.
Not my idea, it was blackmail.
Well, what have you done?
I've been
nosy,
don't
I? Done nothing. Just asked a favour. Carry on.
What?
Isn't Mitch coming?
Yes. Come on, Debbie, get in.
down to you if it all goes horribly wrong.
Oh, no. Go on, best be the editor.
Again? We mightn't.
All right. 5 minutes, no more. Go on. Now, Carter, any bloody nonsense or I'll tear your bollocks off, all right?
All right.
Go on,
Carter. I don't get you.
What's there to get?
Sometimes you're really nice.
Sorry?
No, I mean, I can have a normal conversation with you.
Yeah?
Why were you so pissy before?
I don't know. A few things on my mind at the moment.
Are they going to charge you?
You know, with this murder.
What? With Gary Walters? I never murdered Gary Walters. I never even touched him.
He was beaten up.
I know.
Everyone's sane. And the police came to see you.
Oh, that was a... Bloody hell. Debbie. Did you think I'd beaten him? No, I didn't. I know bloody did, but it wasn't me. I'm not like that. I suppose you think we're all like that.
I don't know.
Lovely day for it.
I'll be around when he's gone to work then.
Ta-da! What do you think? Me and our Sarah have been at him all night.
Oh, bloody hell, Denise.
What?
I'm not walking around with that. Look all right, Pratt.
You don't have to walk round with it. Just stand there on the picket line. I didn't know what to put. You think of a snappy slogan, then.
I can't.
Well, I'm going to have a bit of a kip and I'll come up to the hospital after.
No, no, it's all right.
All the wives are coming.
Top bridges in! Management out! Top bridges in! Management out!
Larry Jones from the union has put out a press statement, so that pack's going to be on us soon. He said, say nothing to nobody.
I got Sarah set up with
you.
What?
You might be on the news.
Oh, sod it.
Scab!
You are tasting a hot chili pepper. Feel it burning your tongue. Cool it down with ice cream. Now open your eyes. Okay. Now, I want you to imagine that there is someone out there you want to speak with, and I want you to tell that person exactly how you feel about them.
I'd like to imagine that it's Terry out there.
Not this week, Donna. Debbie, you haven't done this.
It's just sort of about being here, really. You sort of start off hating it and feeling scared all the time. And then you sort of get used to it. And sometimes you can forget who you are. I don't want to forget. I'm getting out. I just sort of want it all back, really. You know, be me, all right? And I don't care, because I am all right. So are you.
Denise?
I'm not cleaning it up.
No, I know. I will. I'm sorry.
You don't know what it was like. All of us going up the hospital, and you're not there. And then they said you'd gone in.
Well, sod them. Sod the bastards, Denise. Look what they've done in our kitchen.
They haven't done that. They couldn't have done.
Well, somebody did. Why are you sticking up for them?
But it's family. It's your brother-in-law on that picket line and your friends.
Friends?
Yeah, friends. And you have shit on them, Mitch. You know it's not fair what's happening to Don, and you're deliberately turning your back on him. Is it me? Have I done something?
What are you talking about? It's got nothing to do with you and me.
But it has. I went up there to support you, and you're gone, and I don't know why.
Because it isn't right. That's why.
Listen, Mitch. Forget it. Please. Gary's dead. I know you're gutted, but Don's gutted too. He just doesn't show it.
Why are you doing this? I mean, why are you taking everybody else's side? And never mind, eh? I mean, you say you want to support me. Okay, well, bloody well support me then. Well, tell me I'm right.
Bloody hell. I can't.
She'd lost her place at the RSU in Wales. Someone else was sent there from Crown Court. It always happens. She'd be down the medical ward a couple of days. It wasn't as bad as it looked. Mitch, I've asked Stuart to replace you.
Why?
It's not... I think you fitted in here really well. Much better than I expected. But my first responsibility has to be to the patients. To Debbie.
Well, like letting her wander around with a pair of garden shears.
I can defend that, and I'm going to defend it all the way up the hospital. You know she thinks she's in love with you.
Oh, for God's sake.
These are vulnerable women, Mitch. And I'm not saying that you did anything that... But maybe you paid her too much attention and she's...
Oh, no. No, that's where your theory falls down, Viv. I mean, if she was so keen on me, she'd be delighted she wasn't going to leave us because then she could still see me every bloody day.
As a patient, Mitch, and she doesn't want to be your patient.
You know what you're sending me back to, don't you? Can I at least keep this?
Debbie shouldn't have taken it down. It wasn't hers to give away.
Where's my picture? What did you do with my picture? She shouldn't have taken my picture, little bitch. She's fucking mental!
Back, Mitch. Should find things running pretty smoothly, despite we brought in staff from other wards. It's not ideal, but...
Right.
Mitch. Why did you cross the picket line?
I have a meeting with John Dunn and an executive from the union tomorrow. We can get this whole business sorted out if someone speaks up.
What about the patients?
Oh, come on. You know what patients' evidence is worth.
Hello. Yeah, I have the number of a flower shop, please. No, one that delivers. Near Town Yard. Yeah.
Several males within a group, but the dominant male will always take precedence. And if the size of the nose gland is a sign of majesty...
Shouldn't some of these be in sex matters?
He seems to have his chances with this female.
Yeah. Terry?
A dominant male repeatedly engaged...
Terry?
Carefully spotting...
Why are you in the group?
It's not enough staff.
Well, don't just sit there, go up in at the telly. Have a game of pool or something.
Can't, it's not enough staff.
Well, come on, I'll give you a game. I know you're useless, I'll give you a game start. Keith, do you want the computer on?
In their incessant search.
You're all right. Let's have the computer on and that bastard telly off. Right. Okay. Telly's off. You don't need to sit there and gawp at it. Set them up, Telly. Go on.
Dad.
Yeah, Richard. Piss off. You're not even supposed to be in here.
Tabloids.
I see you, Bridges. What's this? The Lone Star Saloon? Yes, please, Roger.
Sorry, we don't serve scabs.
Here you go.
Cheers, Jay.
Just the one, Mitch, eh?
Where's Dickhead, then?
Is that what you come here for? Fisticuffs with Don?
No. Too quiet.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Well, at least I won't end up a pisshead like you, Jerry. The bastards won't even serve me.
It's your own fault.
Man's gotta do. Anyway, what if I don't? This strike is cock and you know it. You're having a go at the management, they're not gonna give in. And who gives a shit what happens to the patients?
I ain't got nothing yet. Union's been in touch. Don goes in the early shift tomorrow. If it doesn't work, patient still hooked up.
You can't do that. Jesus, Jerry. What's he going to do to Dan? He's going to freak. You can't let him do that.
Yeah, if it doesn't cause a fuck up, there's no point, is there?
Oh, this is shit. Mr. Dom!
You heard about the lock-in?
Yeah.
You can't let them do that. That's going to do the patients' heads in. Caging them up. They won't know what the hell's going on. I'm telling you, it's going to be horrible.
Yes, well, I agree.
Look, if I tell you that I saw Don Bridges deliberately assault Gary Walters, not in the dining room, but after in seclusion, yeah, when Gary was under control, giving no resistance, yeah, if I tell you I had to stop Don Bridges from kicking the fucking shit out of Gary Walters, will you go and see someone tomorrow and get this stopped? They can't support Don if there's actual proof of what he did.
Is this just your word against his?
Yeah, but...
I've just had a phone call about you.
Well, of course you have. The bastard's out to get me.
No, it's not about this. It was from the Stirner unit in Manchester. One of our patients was transferred there yesterday.
So?
Well, that patient has alleged sexual abuse.
Oh, what the... Who?
Debbie Harrison. You were working closely with her in Linnet Ward. Well, she's alleged abuse on several occasions, the most serious being on a ward outing when apparently you persuaded two other patients to leave you alone with her.
That's a load of bloody lies.
Well, did you send her some flowers?
No.
Well, were you alone with her on this outing?
Yes!
Well, that was inadvisable. Look, I can't do this here. Come and see me tomorrow morning in my office, about 10 o'clock.
And you'll suspend me?
It's a very serious allegation.
It's all for bloody lie. Did she say that?
Tomorrow, Trevor.
Who told her to say that?
Oh, I wish I'd never had that phone call.
Did Debbie say that? Did Debbie Harrison say that? She never bloody said that, did she, Doug? You're a bloody liar!
You must have done.
Oh, you will have me down as a 9-to-5 man. Until the hospital has completed its inquiries into the allegations made against you, you are still suspended from all your duties.
That's all we wanted to hear.
Think about what you're doing.
And you.
My door's still locked. Come on.
They've smashed the miners. They've smashed the teachers.
And now, with the full backing of the management of this hospital, the government are trying to smash us. Yeah. They are not concerned with public security and safety. They're only concerned with looking good. Yeah. Because we are trying to...
Open the fucking door, will you? Open the fucking door!
It's a mad world.